49 and then leaving and entering into 50. Well, it's nice to become senior, but it's always sad. You know, you feel, I was telling my family, "Arey, yaar, one more year less to live." But then my family says, "One more year, you have gained a lot of experience in 1 year." So it's a gaining of experience. I take it that way, that every day that we age, we are always getting something new, and we experience something new, and we should always take this experience forward. I've always been fascinated by, you know, trying to help people. Just today morning, I was reading the Times of India, and literally every newspaper today is screaming about this 7th April, you know, World Health Day. And one thing that caught my eye today morning was, there was a small, there was too much matter to read, and I hardly had the time to read it. But I just, you know, it was one caption on the left side in Times of India, I think. It was by a senior doctor, I don't know his name, but I will go home, cut that article, cut that small quote and keep it. He says the reason why senior citizens suffer, why do they suffer? We all suffer, but why do senior citizens suffer? So they asked him his opinion, and he gave it in three lines, and it really made me understand what I'm trying to also understand for so many years. He said, majority of our senior citizens underplay their problem or their ailment. You know, if they've got a problem, they will not state the true fact about their problem, or they'll hide it from the family. We should not tell my family that I'm suffering. So that is one part, that majority of our senior citizens continue to suffer because they are not open about their problem or how much they are suffering. They don't tell that to their family, immediate family, for the fear that maybe my children may not like to help me, or I don't want to put an additional burden on them. You know, that Indian family, mummy, daddy, they don't want to burden their children with their suffering. And he said, the second reason why they suffer is, they don't act timely. They don't act timely on that problem. It's the right, you know, I was just reading, the right information at the right time for the right person can be a powerful medicine. Okay? So, what we people have to, be aware actually, is that many people are suffering, many people. We've been a regular speaker in this library for many years, especially since it started. We've been here, regularly speaking in Times of India, all over the country, or on TV every night, for the past 6 years. But what we people have realized is that majority of the people want to hear somebody speak, but they don't know to act on it. Okay? We are speaking every night on Asta. Every night, me and Shilpa, what are we doing? We are there for the past 6 years. Every night we are speaking. Okay, last night was my birthday, so my son, I gave him my mobile, and literally, I had so many phone calls last night. Everybody is asking my son, and I didn't pick up the phone. I was tired. I was sleeping, and my son was answering my phone, and he said, "Come on," he says, "Amka birthday, or so many people are phoning in." You know, literally at 1 a.m. in the morning, I received around 10-12 calls. What did they want? They wanted treatment. Okay, they all want treatment. But when we tell them, phone us back in the morning, sir is sleeping, but naturally somebody is going to sleep at 1 a.m. And the first thing I would do, I mean, if I was suffering, is 8 o'clock or 10 o'clock, I would phone. I would phone at 10 o'clock, because I saw something last night which I feel can help me, but we want it at that moment. We want it at 1 a.m. We are not willing to put an effort next morning around 10 o'clock. Okay, I've had my breakfast. I think Dr. Singh must have also had his breakfast. So let me phone Dr. Singh at 10. No, nobody's phoned me till now. I've got different phone calls from different numbers, but all the phone people who phoned me at 1 a.m. in the morning have not called back yet. Okay, so what is expected is, too much is expected of everybody. Without we trying to, we means the patient trying to move in that direction. Now I'll give you my example. I'm basically a civil engineer. Okay, I suffered with my ulcerative colitis. It's well documented in many Google searches on the net. Times of India, you name it, and they've interviewed me. I've had full pages devoted to me. I was in Africa, full page devoted to me about why I'm doing this and what type of benefit I got from alternate medicine. I said, the reason why I benefited is I tried to get well. I didn't ask anybody for a guarantee. I just read an article and I went to the writer of the article, and I'm talking of way back in 98-99 when you didn't have a mobile and you had to book a telephone, and it took 20 years for a telephone to be delivered to your house. Nowadays you just walk into your store and you pick up any number of SIM cards you want. So in those days I went hunting for that editor of that article, hunting literally. It took me 4 days to hunt him down, and I got him, and he said, oh, this gentleman is in this part of town. And then I went to that part of town and I talked to him. I said, look, I've got ulcerative colitis, I've been suffering for 13 years, can you help me? I didn't ask him anything else. I said, I'm suffering, can you help me? And he said, yeah, we can try. I said, good, go ahead, start trying. And he tried, and then gradually my life was back on track. That's when I started getting motivated about alternate medicine. I realized that there's so much that is available to us today that we people simply do not act on it. Majority of the people I have known, I can show you over thousands and thousands of numbers in my diaries. Thousands and thousands, literally, where kidneys have failed, where they got hepatitis. But the only thing that they want is treatment with a guarantee. That's all they want. When they'll come to a person like you and me, who's the alternate practitioner, the first thing they will say is, we want treatment, and how fast can we get well? They don't realize that to get unwell, it took them quite some time. So to do that, unwell period is going to take some time to regain that well. So you cannot go back to 100% efficiency, but you can definitely go back to 90-95%, provided you do it regularly. Okay. Now, I did alternate medicine. I did many. You name it, I did it. Why? I wanted to see which method could assist me to get better. No method is complete on its own. I just received a phone call yesterday from a leading a patient in Baroda. She's a radiologist. Just yesterday morning the phone came to me. She said, I had a pain in my neck, a normal pain. Now what does a radiologist do? She went in for a MRI scan, right? Machine is there. So rather than spend 7,000 rupees, so she spent that 5 minutes in that machine. And you know what came? I was shocked. She has a tumor from C2 to C7. That tumor is located within the confines of the spinal cord. Okay, within. It's not stuck outside the vertebra. It's not stuck outside the spinal cord, but it lies within the depth and thickness of the spinal cord. Okay. I told her, I said, I do not see any surgeon in the world who can operate on you. I'm not a doctor, but I understand the logic. You have a tumor which is in five of her vertebra inside the spine. Now how do you expect to cut open five vertebra, and open the vertebra? You take out the spinal cord, you open the spinal cord, and then you try to remove a tumor which is within. Okay, and you know what she asked me? Kitna der mein guarantee hai ki aap theek kar denge? Can you imagine that coming from a MD radiologist? I said, I doubt, madam, if there's any doctor in India, forget India, in the world who can take up your case. So what happens is, one has to be realistic in our expectation from different methods. I told her, let us be realistic in what can medical science do to you. She said nothing. In my opinion, she said, I don't think. So I said, then why should we think that we alternate people can give you a very good method, but we can help you get well gradually. I told her, I said, we should think that if we treat you properly, maybe the size of the, you know, syringomyelia within that spinal cord might reduce, and if there's collection of fluid or some fibrotic matter, that can be reduced. So gradually, time will tell. Otherwise, what is the outcome? I said, the outcome is quite, you know, dangerous, because if it's right in the neck, and imagine what will happen to the entire body. So there are shortcomings in all methods, but they are there. They exist, that we can overcome treatment. Okay, for today, that was some brush up on alternate medicine. We've prepared a list, okay, for senior citizens. We prepared two lists. One is a list on various tips for good health, the diet tips for better health and recovery. Second is, we prepared a second page which has got around 10 to 12 day-to-day problems which most of our senior citizens face. Okay, now giving out these papers. Just to give you a feedback, this contains treatment for how to improve your immunity, depression, knee pain, constipation, blood pressure, cervical pain, piles, insomnia, energy points, and general health. Okay, what we have tried to do is, we've tried to understand the basic problems that any senior citizen can face day to day life, and what are the simplest ways that the senior citizen can read this page and try to help themselves, and at the same time share this knowledge with fellow people in your society or in your building. And at the same time, the idea is to spread a message that what is the simplest way that you can take care of your piles. Of course, you require better treatment, but there are simple ways that can assist somebody. So these are two pages which we just penned down yesterday, and we made it out. Now we'll give, pardon?